Students, welcome to the second semester video. In today's video we are going to see the unit 3 integral calculus. In integral calculus there are two chapters, chapter number 5 definite integration and chapter number 6 application of definite integrals. So today we are going to see chapter number 6 application of definite integral. So let's start. So learning outcomes, after watching this video, student, you will be able to solve area under the curve, then you will be able to find area between two curves, and you also will be able to find the volume of solid of revolution. So let's start. So application of definite integral. So the area under the curve of a function, the area between two curves and the volume of the solid of revolution. As I told you earlier, application of definite integral is to find the area under the curve, area between two curves and volume of the solid of revolution. Now in calculus, the integral of a function is an extension of the concept of sum. Now the process of finding integrals is called integration. The process is usually to find a measure of totality such as area, volume, mass, displacement, etc. So whenever we are interested in your syllabus, whenever we are interested in finding the area and volume, then we will use the concept of definite integral. By using this definite integral, we are going to find area and volume. So the integral would be written integral fx dx. This sign represent the integration that we know. Then a and b represent the endpoint of the interval. F of x is the function we are integrating, known as the integrand. And dx is the notation for the variable of integration. Now integrals discussed in this project are termed definite integrals. So we are going to use the concept of definite integral, right? Integral a to b f of x dx, we are going to use this concept of definite integral in finding the area and volume. So let's start. So first example or first application is to find the area under the curve. So as you can see, the example is here. What is the area between the curve y is equal to x square minus 4 and the x axis. So the standard shape R, the standard area is the area that we want, right? This is the standard, the shaded area. This is the shaded area in which we are interested. We are interested in finding this shaded area. Now, how to find this shaded area? We can easily work out that the curve cross the x-axis when x equal to minus 2 and x equal to 2. To find the area, therefore, we integrate the function between minus 2 and 2. Now integral, what we are going to do? We are going to integrate x square minus 4 from minus 2 to 2. Why? Because x values are minus 2 to 2. Okay. So we integrate minus 2 to 2. Function is x square minus 4 dx. Now let's integrate this. So integral of x square is x cube upon 3. Minus integral of 4 is 4x. So integral of 4 is 4x. Then limit of integration is minus 2 to 2. So in place of x, first we substitute the upper limit. Then we substitute the lower limit. So it will be 8 upon 3 minus 8. Then minus, now we substitute lower limit means minus 2. So minus 8 upon 3, then minus minus plus 8. Okay, so that is equal to 16 upon 3 minus 16. So that is equal to minus 10.67. Now, as I am getting the area as negative, so the area is negative because it is below the x-axis. So this negative sign indicates that this area is below the x-axis, and that's why we get area as negative. Okay, now area above the x-axis on the other hand gave positive result. Okay, so to find area under the curve, we have the equation of a curve. Okay, so what we have to do, we have to find the points of x, and that point of x will be limit of integration. So integral a to b y dx. Okay, so first example, find the area under the curve y is equal to x square from x equal to 0 to x equal to 3 with x axis. Okay, so the area under the curve y is equal to x square from x equal to 0 to x equal to 3 with x axis is as shown in figure. So as you can see, from x equal to 0, so 0 to 3, this is the x value. Okay, so when x is 0, y will be 0, so this point. When x is 1, then y will be 1, so 1 point. When x is 2, then y will be 4, okay, so on. Then when x is minus 1, y will be 1. When x is minus 2, y will be 4. Okay, so the graph looks like this. Curve will be like this. Okay, now area between 0 to 3. That means we are interested in this much area. So how to find that? For that, we have to integrate from 0 to 3 y dx. Y is what? Y is x square. Now, integral of x square is x cube upon 3. Then we put the limit of integral 0 to 3. So, limit of, first we have to substitute the upper limit. So, upper limit is 3. 3 cube upon 3 minus, when x is 0, lower limit is 0, then it will be 0. So, that is equal to 9 square unit. Okay. So, that is the answer. Next, example 2. Find the area bounded by the curve y is equal to sin x and the x axis from x equal to 0 to x equal to pi. So, the required area is as shown in the figure. So, x equal to 0 to x equal to pi. So, x equal to 0 here, x equal to pi is here. Okay. When x equal to 0, then y is equal to sin 0. And sin 0 is 0. When x equal to pi, then y is equal to sin pi. Sin pi is again 0. When x equal to pi upon 2, then y is equal to sin pi upon 2, and sin pi upon 2 is 1. So this point is 1. Okay. So we are getting this curve and we are interested in this area. So now area is equal to integral 0 to pi y dx. But here y is sin x. So sin x dx. Integral of sin x is minus cos x. Then we put limit of integral as 0 to pi. So that will be minus outside cos pi minus cos 0. So minus 1 minus 1. So that is equal to 2 square units. See one more example. Find the area bounded by the curve y is equal to 1 plus x cube plus 2 sin x from x equal to 0 to x equal to pi. Here, equation means equation for the curve is different. Here, y is 1 plus x cube plus 2 sin x. Again, we use the same formula. So, we know that area is integral a to b y dx. This is the formula for area under the curve. Now, A and B points are given. So, it will be 0 to pi. Then y is 1 plus x square plus 2 sin x, okay, dx. So integral of 1, integral of 1 is x. Then integral of x cube is x raised to 4 upon 4. Then 2 is constant, so that will come outside the integral. Integral of sin x is minus cos x. Then we put the limit of integral 0 to pi. So first term will be pi minus 0. Then 1 upon 4 is constant, so it will come outside. Then we put x raised to 4. In that we put the upper limit, so that will be pi raised to 4. Then minus 2. Then cos x. In cos x we put the upper limit, so it will be cos pi minus lower limit, so cos 0. So that is equal to pi minus 0 is pi. Then plus pi raised to 4 upon 4 minus 2. Cos pi is minus 1. Cos 0 is minus 1. So minus 2 into minus 2. So plus 4. So this is the area of given term. See one more example. Here what is given? Find the area between the line y is equal to 2x and x axis and the coordinate x equal to 1 and x equal to 3. So line y is equal to 2x, so we get this straight line. Then x equal to 1 and x equal to 3, so we are interested in this shaded area. Now area formula, area is equal to integral 1 to 3 y dx. Y is what? Y is 2x. So 2 constant, so it will come outside. Then integral of x is x square upon 2, limit of integral 1 to 3. Okay, in place of x we substitute the upper limit, so we get 3 square minus 1. Okay, so 9 minus 1, so that is equal to 8 square unit. So with this I am concluding the first video of application of definite integral. Hope you will like this video. So thank you, students.